Okay, that should be good. I'm gonna lower it a tiny bit more. Okay. Yeah, that looks good. Levels look good. Yeah, it looks good. Just gonna spam my keyboard to make sure levels are good. Yep. Okay. Gonna get out my faithful sniffing tool. Okay. So, I'm gonna start by pointing out just a really basic thing that applies to both species matchups. It's really important for both. Okay. So, when Falco is on the ground, I'll just go with this one. So, when Falco's on the ground, his effective threat range stops right about here. Because right about here is about the furthest he can jump if he has full momentum. If Unga does an immediate dash and then short hop, he can reach right about there with either a short hop laser or a short hop aerial. And it's really important that you keep in mind both the short hop laser and the aerial, because if he does the laser, he can still just like shine or grab after it hits. And he can also time the laser so that it's actually safe shield pressure. So that's really important to remember. I think, if I recall correctly, laser does 8 frames of shield stun. So your normal landing is 4 frames a leg, so that means if Falco is frame perfect, he can turn lasers into about 4 or so frames with advantage if he gets like the perfect lowest laser. If he shines, it doesn't really matter how tight his execution is as long as he gets it within a 4 frame window. And then of course, defensive options in this game aren't really that good. Even if you're Sheik, you're looking at like a frame, you're looking at a frame 6 Nair or a frame 8 grab out shield. So what that means is that it's really important, really, really, really important that you either stay outside this range or you stay in it somewhere in here. So just keep that in mind. If you're not keeping that in mind while you're playing, that's definitely one of the biggest mistakes you can make. That's a big reason why you see so many Sheik players kind of messing around in this area of the screen when they're playing Falco. Because if they're over here, that puts them in perfect position to F-tilt or like short hop back fair, short hop like dash back, short hop forward, like dash back, short hop bear, even rising Nair. And that's also why so many Sheik players will do those kind of like aerials in place when they're at this range. And of course, if you're like right here, and you don't, if you're right here, you can also just boost grab them, which is really important to remember. Because if the Falco is dashing forward for longer, like if he's just dashing forward to right about there, right? And then if you're right there, you're just gonna be able to boost grab no problem. So keep that in mind. Anyways, moving on. Let's see what the first. Actually, I'll watch the first talk and then go from there. Two. Okay, it looks like you more or less know what you're doing. Yeah, get the tech chase, let's go. Okay, drop tech chase, that's alright. Oh, this guy's going for tech chases? Okay, shooting the gun a lot, I see. Okay, so a big thing I'm noticing right away is that your grounded movement is really not that clean at all, which is a pretty big problem. So I'll just open up Notepad. So work on cleaning up your dash stance and grounded movement in general. Use Foxtrot dash, wave dash, dash, crouch, etc. to build a functional dash dance. to build a bear. That's a good term for it. To build a DT. Okay. And this is really important. Really super duper important. Okay. Okay, I'm also gonna add in platform movement. Also work on platform movement. Keeping it as fast as possible. Don't your inputs. Keep them clean. Okay. So it definitely looks like you know what you're doing. It's just these kind of small mistakes that are really gonna be problems. Okay. Alright, buddy. So when you're landing from this needle, so after your needle, right? You should be, so like when you're right about here, you should be checking what the Falco is doing. So you should be checking. Okay. So when you're in this kind of situation, right, you're landing from a needle, needle is going the wrong way. I assume that's a tech error. Right, I assume that's a missed input. But anyway, so when you're landing from this needle, you're gonna be right here, right? And the Falco is all the way in the corner. He has no space to dash back laser with, which is really important because dash back laser is really fucking good. It's one of his best options. And you're also in perfect back air range. Like if you back air, it's gonna cover like up until about here or so. So what this means is that if you land immediate shield drop aerial, you can actually do a really effective, like you can actually wall Falco out really effectively. And because Falco doesn't really have great options for beating like kind of this space right here in front of him, because he's looking at like maybe like forward airing or like maybe turn around up tilt if he wants to stay in place, but that's the dangerous option. Like that's dangerous because he's committing, like if you just wait him out, like if you wait, confirm, see the up, like confirm that he's doing an up tilt and then back air, like then shield drop back air, then he's just pretty much dead if you get the edge card. Which means that he's not, and because like, what if you're Falco, right? You don't want to be right here challenging Sheik with up tilt, you want to be right here. You want to be directly under Sheik. So what this means is that this back air, landing, shield drop back air, is really good in this spot, and I think it's a big mistake that you jumped away from it. Like, okay, so when you're in shield, right, you gotta shield drop air here. You really gotta. It's like he was trying to beat out shield drop back air with that up smash, and he was forced to try and beat it out with up smash because he had no space to dash back laser with, because he's literally all the way in the corner. So that's just a really important general concept to keep in mind, that walling gets a lot better when your opponent is literally all the way in the corner. Because that's just a fundamental fighting games thing. So watch your Street Fighter, pay attention to watch Street Fighter or another like kind of more basic fighting game, and pay attention to how both players play when one of them is cornered. Like when there's literally no screen space to move back with, because that's a really important general concept for any fighting game, even Melee. But it's also important to realize that if you don't have the tech skill, like if you don't have the execution to move around in Melee, it doesn't really matter as much. Which is why Sheik players wave dash back so much, because not many Sheik players have a really good dash dance. And wave dash back is amazing as Sheik. And so is wave dash forward, actually. So is wave dash in place. So it's really important to keep in mind. So I'll add in work on executing shield drops as fast as possible after landing on platform. I'm going to add a timestamp. So 48-23. Give up a fantastic bear. Instead, full hopping away. And that, I don't think you... I'm pretty sure the full hop was intentional. If you're in chat... Are you in chat right now? Common or coffee? Okay, so someone's watching, not common or coffee, but anyways. Keep that in mind if you're watching this when you... If you're watching this when I upload it to YouTube, keep that in mind, it's really important. You don't want to give up opportunities like this. And honestly, that's... I could cut the analysis right there. Like, I think that's... This is already a lot of stuff to practice. Like, this is... You gotta practice cleaning up your grounded movement, clean up your platform movement, and executing shield drops as fast as possible. So I'm just gonna post this... in Discord. So I'll just, I mean, honestly, I think that was a lot, so I'll just keep on watching, see what this looks like. Okay, yeah, like, it really feels like you know what you're doing. Okay, so there's... It's so important that you don't miss the cell cancel. Oh my god. 48, 28, you miss. Really important. Don't cancel. I assume because... Okay, this dash attack was probably a mistake. Okay, so I'm assuming what happened here is that right here, you're trying to input a wave dash back, which doesn't really make too much sense. So maybe you notice that you missed the L cancel and you kind of just panic rolled away. You rolled, like, panic roll behind, which isn't... I don't think that's great, even if you're Mutu King. Like, even if you have the edge guards of Mutu King and you can capitalize off back throwing Falco right here, that's just really not a good decision to make. Also, after this back air, you should be either short hopping again to pressure him, dashing back and then dashing forward to set up a, like a boost grab opportunity, or just like running forward and grabbing him. Those are like kind of the three main options you need to keep in mind when you're doing this kind of shield pressure. So I'll get an Uncle Punch. Get an Uncle Punch and grind out your... So what happened here? Why are you trying to dash attack? Oh, okay, I see, okay. Yeah, that actually, I would do this dash attack too. Like 9 times out of 10 I would do this dash attack. Although, something you can do instead of this dash attack is dash forward from right about here. Actually, I don't need this to be cool. So right about here, you can just short hop back fair, and unless, because he's probably gonna be shielding after he whiffs this move, right? Just because he's in danger of getting dash attacked. So if to make the dash attack a mix up and make him have to play a guessing game with you, you could grab here, or you could short hop back, like right about here, and then fair him. And that would be a pretty effective little mix up sweep. Because the dash attack beats the up tilt, which beats the fair, and also probably loses to a grab if you execute the grab correctly. And then, like, I guess Shine beats the grab and dash attack if he's, like, frame perfect, basically. Because, like, if you look at, like, when the hit happened, like, okay, so, like, yeah, if he shines frame perfectly, he just gets you, and he can just, like, shine back at you, but that's a silly thing to be like to try and play around when you're at this level. It's really just remember your three core options are dash attack, grab, and aerial, and you gotta force them to respect all three of those. Okay. Okay. So, really important thing to pay attention to. Notice that the needle is not going to hit because he's not right here, which is where the needle range is. This is actually really good positioning by the Falco. Hats off to him. So, because he's positioned right there, he can just see you running off and then just react with up tilt. Because he's predicting that you're going to run off fair, and he just confirms his prediction when he sees you run off and he up tilts. So, I mean, yeah, really just keep in mind not to fall directly on top of Falco like this, because again, Falco and most characters want to be, well, pretty much every character wants to be directly below Sheik, because Nair, not good at beating opponents below you, Downer, not good at beating opponents below you, and other than that, you pretty much don't have any options for challenging this space right here, because remember, Fair has a swing. I think one thing I'm noticing is that you kind of just need to improve your platform decision making too. Like, that's a really important part of what makes players like Plup so good, like Plup and Spark, all those new school Sheiks. Is that not only is their tech skill and platforms really good, but so is their execution, like, so is their decision making. Like, they have execution and decision making, and they also have the punishes, of course. And punishes are, in Melee, I think, a part of execution, just because, like with reaction tech chasing, you can grind out reaction tech chasing and improve your tech chasing, just because reactions are a trainable thing, and you can train yourself to react to the different frames of the tech animations, and you can train yourself to recognize at what point they diverge, and then just confirm your prediction, just confirm your reaction based on those timings. I think one thing I've heard recommended is that you, I think by someone, I don't know who, it might have been Drugfox, is to set a metronome to the beat, like to the timing where the tech animations become differentiable, and then just internalize that timing and like internalize that timing and just use that as your basis. Like use that as your like your check mark, right? Like the point where you check exactly what your opponent's doing. Okay, I'm gonna see if you're in the Discord again. Guess not. Honestly, I think that's about all you need. Honestly. Okay, so anyways. Ooh, that was the... I don't know about challenging Fossil in that situation, just because of how good Packer is. Okay, good shield pressure. Alright. Ooh. Did he read you? Yeah, he read you. He read you like a book. Ooh, okay, yeah, you definitely have some good ideas, I can tell. Just gotta work on that execution. Ooh, you got good platform movement when you're feeling it. Alright. Okay, don't... I guess that back row is fine. Because it was really close to being a strong hit. Okay. Okay, I think, yeah, your decision making is definitely pretty good, I can tell. Yeah, walling him out, good stuff. Ooh, almost. Okay, I agree. Yeah, I agree with most of the decisions you're making, honestly. It's really just the execution that's messing you up. And just kind of like, the more there are specific situations on the platforms that you don't really have a firm handle of, that's causing some problems. Okay. Oh, again, falling directly on top of Falco, just getting, like, falling into that up-tilt spacing. Oh, this Falco's feeling himself. Okay, bad laser, though. Oh, yeah, work on your shield drops. For the love of God, work on your shield drops, make it as fast as possible, please, for me. For your boy. Okay. Swap. Ooh. That was a slick platform cancel. Oh my god. Ugh. That's so good. You guys are really evenly matched still, I can tell. Okay, I'd just like to point out... There's that situation again. It feels like... This is autopilot. That runoff there feels like it's really autopilot. Okay. Oh, I still. Oh, okay, get it. Please kill the Falco for me. Alright. Yeah, so in summation, good ideas, good decision making, not so much good tech skill, and not so much good decision making when in certain situations on the platforms. Also, just you're lacking speed in your shield drops, you're lacking cleanliness in your grounded movement. There's kind of some general slop I think the general slop would go away the more you play. And the more you work on your punish game, and the more you do analysis of situations. And the more you watch Plup against bad Falcos. Or Spark against bad Falcos, or Drug Fox against bad Falcos. Swedish against bad Falcos. Honestly, Santiago's Sheik against bad Falcos, if you can find VODs of that. I'll play Santiago versus West Balls from some random SoCal tournament that Santiago beat West Balls at. So yeah. Just remember, keep in mind, these three things right here. Work on cleaning up your dash dance and grad movement in general. Use Foxtrot, dash to wave dash, dash to crouch, etc. to build a dash dance. Also work on cleaning up your platform movement while keeping it as fast as possible. Don't rush your inputs. Keep them clean above all else, and work on executing shield drops as fast as possible after landing on the platform. So yeah, I'll cut the VOD.